erosion treatment for dam foundations and speakers for today's expert lecture is Mr. Miraj Thakkar. Sir has completed his bachelor's degree in civil engineering from University of Mumbai. Sir is having a lot of industrial experience. Sir has worked in Geo Profiles Engineering and Service Limited as a site engineer from 2020 to 2021. Currently, Miraj sir is working as a engineer in Best Geotechnical Private Limited. So, all of you welcome our expert for today's lecture, Mr. Miraj Thakkar, sir. Sir, over to you. Your mic is, audio is off.
I'm audible, right?
Yeah. You can start.
Is my screen visible, sir?
Yes, sir.
Now?
Yes, easy.
Okay. So, good morning to one and all present over here. Myself, Miraj Thakkar. And today I'm going to present a very interesting topic, which is foundation treatment of dams. I'm currently working as a project engineer in Best Geotechnics Private Limited, which is a geotechnical design consultancy firm. Okay. These are the contents of my presentation. Introduction, components, types, common failure, geotechnical investigation, treatment methods. Okay. So everyone knew that what is dam. Okay. A dam is a structure built across a stream or a river to hold water back. Dams can be used to store water, control flooding and generate electricity. All the students here might know that what exactly the function of the dams. Okay. Now I would like to talk about the components of the dam. Okay, so this is a typical cross section of a dam, in which we are here we can see that the upstream face and downstream face. Upstream face is the face in which water is retained, and downstream is the face in which water is dam is called as hill, and this portion of the dam is called as toe. And this portion, the blue color one, is all called as spillway, through which the water is discharged by opening the valves. Okay, now we have seen the components of the dam. Okay, now let's see what are the types of dam. First one is the functions. Okay, in this, storage dams and diversion dam. These two are the main component of the function of the dam. First is the storage. The dam is used for the storage purpose. And second one is the diversion dam, in which if suppose we have to construct one big dam, for that we need to construct a small dam. So we need to divert the water so that the construction process can take place. According to the shape, first arc dam, second is trapezoidal dam. Arc is the shape. Trapezoidal is also the shape of the dam. So these two are the basic shape of the dam. Third one is materials. The dams are also classified as per materials. First one is stone masonry. Second is RCC. Dams are constructed by using stone masonry materials also, like bricks and stones. And second one is the RCC, which is nothing but concrete. Design. Now dams are also constructed according to the design. So first is the structural, in which it is more further classified as gravity dams, arc dams, buttress dams, earth dams, rock fill dams. Second is the hydraulic, in which again it is classified as overflow, non-overflow dam. So this is the typical classification of the dam, in which all the functions, shape, material, design are classified. Okay, you can do classification as per your requirement, but this is the general type of classification adopted for a typical dam. Now let's see one by one, understand what is exactly masonry dam, earthen dam, rock fill dams. This is the schematic diagram of masonry dam. Sir, my voice is audible, right?
Yes, yes, no issues.
Okay. Schematic diagram of masonry dam. This is the diagram in which you can see that this masonry is built up of bricks and stones. Okay, this is the water level and this is the dam. Okay, and foundation is laid on the rock. Here you can see the Nagarjuna Sagar Masonry Dam is India. This is the real picture of the Nagarjuna Sagar Masonry Dam, which is constructed by using bricks and stones. Second is the concrete dam. Here you can see the diagram of the concrete dam, in which you can see here the whole material is made up of concrete. Okay, this is the downstream phase, this is the upstream phase. Drainage gallery is provided over here. So what happens when the water is sipped, sippage occurs through the dam, the water is collected in this drainage gallery and it is discharged further. This is the heel of the dam, this is the toe. Here you can see the three largest concrete dam, which is in China. This is the largest concrete dam constructed ever in the world, which is located in China, named as Three Gorges Concrete Dam. Third one is the timber dam. This is the schematic dam of frame timber dam. Timber is nothing but a wood, but it is a type of wood. So in initial days, mostly this dam were constructed because of the function of the diversion. Its maximum height can range up to 8 meters. And above 8 meters, it is not structurally stable or it is not economical. So this is the temporary type of dams mostly used for the diversion purpose, for the main construction of the dam. So here you can see that the timber are placed in a framed position, and here is the highest flood level. So this is a typical design of timber dam. Here you can see that one of the real life example of timber creek dam. This is situated in Gulfport, okay, in Southern California. So its main purpose is mostly for diver, and it is a small or temporary type of dam. It is not used on a large scale. Steel dam. Schematic diagram of steel dam. Here you can see that this is the struts. This is the mild steel plate, which is connected with the struts. So the water is written on the upstream side. So this is also a type of temporary structure also, but its height can range up to 15 meters. So it's a little bit of more advantages than timber dam in terms of height, but it is uneconomical since steel is more costly than timber. So this is the Red Ridge Steel Dam, which is located in USA. Okay, this is a real life example. Next is the Earthen Dam. This is a schematic diagram of Earthen Dam. Okay, Earthen Dam means what? The material which is used in the dam are made up of earth material. Earth material means soil, means sand, clay, silt. These are the type of soil which is used to construct this dam. Okay, you can here you can see the middle of the core, which is of made up of clay, and second is here in left side you can see the medium grain sand. Right side also you can see the medium grain sand. That typically depends upon the design of the dam. But the reason for the use of clay in the middle section is because clay has the low permeability. Permeability means the water can pass through the void, the property of the soil in which the water can pass through the soil. So if the clay is used, clay is nothing, why clay? It acts as a barrier. Okay, so water cannot pass through the body of the dam. It can be written over here, and from downwards it can be discharged. This is the Earthen Dam, which is located in Pune. Okay, so this is a typical Earthen Dam in which you can see that the soil is used for constructing the dam. Okay, second is the Rockfill Dam. The name itself suggests the rock fill. Rock means nothing but stones. This is a typical diagram in which you can see the body of the dam is constructed by using stones. Okay, and the facing is made up of concrete for the seepage and permeability purpose. So this is the upstream level, this is the crest of the dam, this is the plinth, and this is the foundation. This is the Mahalalel-Ezhedan Dam, which is situated in Africa, which is a purely rock filled dam. Okay, this entire dam is made up of rocks, the pieces of rocks and stones. Seventh one is the Gravity Dam. What is actually Gravity Dam? This is the most popular type of dam constructed right now. So Gravity Dam is nothing but a concrete dam only, but the forces by exerted by water here, the foundation uplift pressure exerted by water, and its own weight and its own forces, all the forces are taken up by this dam only. So what exactly is that? All the forces, there is no external support, all the forces is taken by its own weight. Okay, so because density unit weight of concrete is more than that of soil, so entire forces and everything is taken up by this only its own self weight. Okay, in short, it means that the weight of the dam is equal to the weight of the pressure exerted on the dam. So whatever pressure is acting on the dam, its weight can sustain. If the pressure is more than its weight, that dam will collapse. So this is a typical gravity dam. And this is a spillway in which the water can pass. This is the Grand Coulee Gravity Dam, which is situated in USA. This is also a type of real-life gravity dam. Next is the Ark Dam. This is a schematic diagram. You can see the shape. The shape is of arc type. So what the advantage of the dam is, when there is a narrow valley, the height of the valley is more. So this type of arc section can be used. The advantage of this arc section is its arc shape can resist the whole pressure exerted on it. So what happens here is the water is written over here. Okay, and the pressure is exerted on this arc section, and here in the two corners there are abutments. So whole load is transferred from this arc section to abutments. It is a similar mechanism of say the arc bridge. You must be aware of the arc section bridge, in which all the load is taken up by the arc and then it is transferred to the abutment of the foundation in the corners. So this is also arc dam, but if you want to make this dam economical, its length means from here to here should be less than the height of the dam. Okay, if the height, if the length of the dam is more, so it becomes uneconomical, and it is most widely used in big and narrow valleys. This is the all other arc dam in Spain. okay, you can see here that this is a valley, okay, deep valley, and the arc is constructed over here, and these are the abutments to which found with the load is transferred. Next one is the buttress dam. What is the buttress dam? Here you can see that the buttress, okay, when the foundation of the soil is a foundation soil is very weak or having low bearing capacity, these additional supports, inclined supports, are given to the dam so that the it can sustain the pressure exerted on it. Okay, so these additional inclined supports are called as buttress. Here you can see that there is a buttress. These are the buttresses, inclined faces. This is upstream. See, this is the schematic, the Daniel Johnson buttress dam. This is situated in Canada. Okay, so the buttress is what is doing is it is giving support to the wall. Okay, so this is a typical example of buttress dam, which is situated in Canada. Okay, next is the embankment dam. Okay, this is the diagram of embankment dam. In what it is similar to the earthen dam, but the difference is that here in the middle it is a core type section given, which is made up of concrete or any suitable hard material, and the core can be ideally placed in the center or moderately sloping top depending on the design. So this is the typically the diagram, schematic diagram of embankment dam. This is the circuit embankment dam, which is situated in Thailand. Okay, so these are the basic which are shown were the most widely used and basic types of dam. Apart from this, there are more number of dams, but these top 10 dams are common, which is widely constructed all over the world. Okay, so till now everyone knew that, okay, what is the dam. You have seen the real picture, the schematic diagram. At least you are aware of the what are the types of top. If someone asks what are the types of dams, you can easily tell at least 4 to 5 dams. Now, common failures of dam. Dam is constructed, okay, no issue, water is retained. But the failures also occurs in dam. Why? There are 3 types of failure. First, we understand that why the failure occurs. See, generally large force is exerted on dam by the water present behind it, in which it is also called as hydrostatic pressure. Means the only large amount of pressure is exerted by this water which is behind the dam. So all the pressure in which causes 3 types of general failure. That is, first one is overtopping. What is overtopping? Overtopping is nothing but if the pressure is more over here, the water will slide over the dam and the erosion will take place in the downstream side. So what will happen, that there are chances of dam to overtopple. It will just overtopple and all the failure will occur. So this is the first type of failure, overtoppling. Second is the foundation failure. Now what will happen, that the water present behind it will try to seep, will try to go will try to pass under the dam. So what will happen is the soil present in below the foundation will try to erode, and if the soil is eroded, the foundation becomes weak, and the problem is that the foundation failure can occur, which will lead to collapse of the dam. Okay. Third is the piping failure, which is also called as seepage. This is the most common type of failure, which is observed in all types of dam. Okay. So what happens here is, this is the water under upstream phase. What happens here is the water tries to penetrate through the body of the dam. Okay. Which is all through, which makes a narrow channel, also called as piping. This phenomenon is called as seepage or piping. This is the most common failure occurring in every types of dam. Okay, so these 3 are the basic general failures of the dam. Okay, so next we will see which are the failures. Okay, failure has occurred, but going little back, I would like to start with the how the dam is constructed actually. What is the starting phase? Okay, so the main important point is the geotechnical investigation. Okay, you must have seen in every starting of the structure there is a geotechnical investigation going on. Why? Because we need to see what is beneath the earth. Okay, whether it is soil, whether it is rock, or so for that we need to do the geotechnical investigation. Okay, so I would like to present one short video just look at it carefully how the soil and rock is extracted from the ground and later it is the analysis is done. Okay, so this is a video. See, this is a typical investigation calx rig. Okay. So this is the drilling is going on. Okay. This rod is called as SPT rod. Okay, here the dimension is marked every 15 centimeter. And then the 75 kg weight is the 63.5 kg of hammer is dropped on up to dropped with a height of 75 centimeter. And later on, the sample is obtained in the split spoon sample. Here you can see the soil sample, which is collected and then noted. Okay. These are the N values, which is used in the design purpose. And when the, and this is the core bit, which is used to cut the rocks. Okay. So again, the barrel is inserted, drilling is done and it is removed. The sample is removed, the bit is opened, and here you can see the rock sample which is obtained from a required depth. Okay, so these are the rock samples. This indicates that how strong, how weak, how loose the rock and the soil is. So this is a typical geotechnical investigation. Okay, so sorry, it was visible?
Yes.
Okay. So this is the geotechnical image. This is the very first stage in every construction project. Either it is dam, it is bridge, or it is retaining wall or anything, building or anything. This is the first stage, geotechnical imaging. We need to see what is under the strata, under the founding strata. So we need to do the geotechnical investigation. Now, geotechnical investigation is done. You get the reports, what is the underlying soil, how it is, how the rock is. Okay, so for the, from the dam point of view, ensuring the dam foundation has capability and strength of withstanding foundation pressure exerted upon it for both wet and dry conditions. Okay, there are two methods: preparing the foundation, grouting the foundation. Grouting the foundation is consolidation grouting, cutting grouting. Okay, these are the methods to strengthen the foundation. If the rock or soil beneath is very weak or it is having a large amount of cracks. So these two methods are adopted to treat the, to make the ground strong for the foundation. So these are the two techniques: preparing the foundation, grouting the foundation. So here I would like to show one more video in which you can clearly see that the preparation of foundation, how it is done. So this is the typical preparation of the foundation of a dam. Here the concrete is laid. Then vibrator is used to compact the concrete. The foundation is laid according to the design. And now you can see that the substructure is built and then the superstructure is constructed. So this is the preparation of the foundation and then the dam is built. Okay. So this is how the foundation is laid. Typical foundation of the dam. foundation is of typically needed for two types. First is for concrete dam, or which also is subclassified as gravity dam, rock fill dam, and everything. So for concrete dam, the foundation preparation is done by preparing a shear key to prevent failure against sliding, overturning, and crushing. So this is the foundation of the dam, in which you can see here the foundation, the shear key. This is the shear key, in which these are the steps. So what will happen, this is the upstream phase. The water pressure will act on the foundation. The foundation will not slide, overturn, or crush due to the pressure, so that the foundation is laid. Okay, in such a manner that all these factors, sliding, overturning, crushing, won't take place. So this is the typical for concrete dam. Okay, this is only for a concrete dam. This is the rock foundation. This is the shear key. This is called a shear key, and these are the steps. Okay, so second is for earthen dam. Excavation and backfill seen in the entire core contact zone and blanket. Special care is needed when filling material consists of silt and dispersive clay. Silt and dispersive clay is nothing but type of soil vulnerable to erosion. This is an earthen dam, which is made up of soil and rocks and earth type of materials. So here you can see that the core is laid. This is the cutoff. Cutoff means the water cannot pass through directly. It has to follow the different paths, so that the whole foundation of the system can be maintained and it will be stable. So this is the typical for earthen dam. Second method is grouting the foundation. I don't know you students know or not what is the grouting. So I will show you one video which will come to know what exactly is the grouting. Okay. Two types of grouting, cement grouting and jet grouting. The function is the same, but the method is different. The drilling is done. The cement grout is, you can see here the cracks are getting filled with cement slurry or the required paste. This cement slurry has filled the cracks of the rocks, also the voids present in the soil. So the water will not pass through here because of this cement slurry. This process is called as grouting. The first drilling is done, then cement slurry is injected with pressure, and after a certain time it hardens into the cracks. So all the cracks beneath the foundation are filled. So this process is called as grouting. This is the second type of method of foundation treatment of dam. Here also there are two sub-methods, consolidation grouting and curtain grouting. First is the consolidation grouting. In this diagram, here you can see that this is a typical diagram of the dam, in which here you can see that exactly center beneath the foundation, these are the drill vertical holes which are made, and this part is called as grout holes, consolidation grout holes. And these holes are designed upon the design primary, secondary, tertiary. Okay, so this is called as consolidation grouting, which is done to fill the cracks of the rocks or the soil under the foundation. So grouting is done to consolidate the entire dam foundation. Drilling of shallow holes, which is also called as B holes, varying from 9 meter to 15 meter in depth through the foundation rock. Location of these holes will be ranged from 5 meter to 20 meter apart. Means the horizontal spacing of the holes in the foundation will be 5 meter to 20 meter, depending on the design. The design engineer will decide how much spacing and how much pressure, how much depth, according to the geotechnical investigation report, is carried out. So drilling of holes is generally done in hill areas. Okay, hill means this side of the dam, because the water because this is the hill, this is the toe. Here it is done more because the water is present over here. So it is the closest area to the water. So mostly this type of grouting is done over the hill side. Okay, so it can cut off the seepage. Post drilling, the cement and water grout is forced into the holes, maintaining a low pressure of around 20 to 40 newton per meter square. Okay, so the pressure maintained while injecting a cement slurry into this is around 30 to 40 newton per meter square, depending upon the design. Okay. So this whole process is consolidation grouting. Second is the curtain grouting. Curtain means what? Curtain means in our when we use in our household, we just tell that put on the curtain. Okay, what it means is a barrier. Okay, this is the type of dam. This is the upstream face. Okay, the water will try to come from here and try to seep over here. So this is the curtain. You can see the curtain grouter. Curtain is nothing but a barrier. To prevent the barrier, so what will happen? The water will not move from here. The water will move from here, from downwards, and go to directly to the downstream face. It will not exert uplift pressure on the dam. So this is the curtain grout hole. Okay, so these are the series of holes which is injected by a cement slurry, and this shape or orientation is called as curtains. Okay, so this is known as curtain grouting. It is mostly used to control the seepage or piping. Drilling a small series of holes through the entire dam, particularly focusing in the leak areas. Okay, so drilling a small series of holes, as I told, that it is the holes are drilled in this whole one line. Okay. Pumping of ultra viscous material through the holes, working downward upwards, bottom upwards. So in this type of dam, what actually happens is, cement is not used. The admixtures and materials like bentonite, clay, and everything is used to pump inside and fill the barrier. Okay. Hardening of this material develops an impermeable curtain without the need of excavation or isolating the area of water. So no heavy excavation is needed. Okay, for laying of concrete and everything, you can just drill the series of holes and you can grout the portion. So this whole process is known as curtain grouting. So this is the whole foundation treatment of dams. Okay, curtain grouting, then consolidation grouting, and the preparation of surface. Okay, so these are all the methods which is adopted to protect the dam from the failure. Okay, so these are the common foundation treatments. These all techniques are adopted before the construction of the dam while the foundation is being built. So curtain grouting, consolidation grouting, preparing the surface, and these are the basic two methodologies available to treat the foundation of the dam. Okay, and I hope you have understood. And at last, I would like to talk about our company, which is named as Best Geotechnics Private Limited. We are geotechnical, geosynthetics, and foundation engineering design consultants. Okay, we do the engineering design of the geotechnical works, and we also do forensic site investigation and asset management. We are a team of geotechnical and highway engineers possessing depth of knowledge and experience of a variety of complex foundation engineering and slope stability issues. So these are the, I hope everyone has understood. If anyone has doubt, you can just raise and ask me. Thank you.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Miraj sir, for giving your valuable time to guide our students.
Welcome.
Now our HOD, Mr. Rohan More sir, has joined. As Miraj Thakkar sir is Rohan sir's student, he would like to say a few words. Sir, please. Rohan sir.
यस सर आवाज आ रहा है
यस सर
थैंक यू सर थैंक यू सर करेक्ट. करेक्ट. अब जितने भी सर कंपटीशन रहेंगे, आप सब स्टूडेंट्स को डेफिनेटली जाना चाहिए उसमें. आपको कोई भी हेल्प चाहिए तो रोहन सर है. रोहन सर आपको कुछ भी अगर कुछ दूसरे लैब यूज करना है कोई कॉलेज के वगैरह, तो सर के बहुत कॉन्टेक्ट है, सर खुद आपको हेल्प कर देंगे. लेकिन अगर आप जाओगे कॉलेजेस में वगैरह, तो आपको पता चलेगा कि आपसे आपको कितना मालूम है खुद को, और आपसे ज्यादा कितने को क्या मालूम है. मालूम हो ना मालूम ठीक है, लेकिन आपको बहुत कुछ नया सीखने मिलेगा वहां पे. आपको नए प्रोजेक्ट आइडियाज मिला. अभी आपका बी बाकी है, बैचलर ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग बाकी आ गए. तो ये सब मैं भी डिप्लोमा में जब था तो मुझे इतना कुछ पता नहीं था. मैं ऐसे ही मतलब प्रेजेंट करने के लिए गया था. फर्स्ट टाइम गया, फर्स्ट टाइम मैं जीत गया था. तो वहां से मुझे थोड़ा मोटिवेशन मिला. मैं जीतते गया सब कॉम्पिटिशन, बहुत सारी मैंने ट्रॉफीज वगैरह जीती. वो सब काम मुझे आया डिग्री में. डिग्री में मैं बहुत लोग से आगे था ऑलरेडी, क्योंकि मैं ऑलरेडी डिप्लोमा में ये सब कर चुका था. तो ये सब आप कंपटीशन में जाओगे, आपको खुद को नॉलेज मिलेगा, आइडियाज मिलेंगे, नए नए लोगों से मिलने मिलेगा, इंडस्ट्री में क्या चल रहा है. दूसरी बात, आपको इंडस्ट्री वाले जो जज आते हैं वहां पे, वो जज आपको पूछेंगे, सवाल पूछेंगे, तो आपको पता चलेगा कि ओके ये भी ऐसा भी होता है, ऐसा भी होता है. तो ऐसा कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. रजिस्ट्रेशन तो मिनिमम रहता है कॉलेजेस का. तो डिपेक्स वगैरह बहुत अच्छी अच्छी कॉम्पिटिशन है, आपको बहुत देखने मिलेगा. और रोहन सर है, आपकी फैकल्टी है, जो भी है उसका हेल्प, सर का हेल्प ले लो. और आप जा सकते हो कहीं भी, बहुत पूरा स्टेट कंपटीशन तो ठीक है, लेकिन आप फिर थोड़ा आपको घूमना भी हो जाएगा बहुत सारी जगह पे, तो आप जा सकते हो ऐसा. क्योंकि देखो मैं सीरियसली बोलता हूँ कि जॉब अगर आपको चाहिए, तो आपने क्या पढ़ाई की है, सबके पास डिग्री है, सबके पास डिप्लोमा है, सिविल है, सबके, आपने एक्स्ट्रा क्या किया हो रहा है. मुझे ये दो कंपनी में मेरे को यही काम आया कि मेरे पास सर्टिफिकेट्स थे, मेरा पेपर रिसर्च पेपर पब्लिश है, मेरे प्रोजेक्ट्स इतने अच्छे थे. तो मुझे ये सब के बारे में ही पूछा कि आपके प्रोजेक्ट के बारे में बताइए, क्या क्या है करके बताओ. तो थोड़ा सा आप एक्स्ट्रा रखोगे अपने सीवी में और ये को, तो आपको अच्छा ऐडअप हो जाएगा. सिर्फ पढ़ाई करने से कुछ नहीं होगा, ये पढ़ाई का यूज वहां पे एक्चुअल में आप प्रोजेक्ट्स वगैरह मॉडल वगैरह के करो, तो आपको और एडवांटेज हो जाएगा. और डिप्लोमा है तो आप बैचलर्स के लिए भी जाओ आगे, और बैचलर्स पूरा कंप्लीट करो. इवन आज बैचलर्स भी कम पड़ रहा है, मास्टर्स के लिए भी जाओ आगे. बहुत सारी फील्ड है, आपको अगर देखना है कितनी फील्ड है क्या है, तो मेरा खुद का वेबसाइट है constructorspeed.com करके, वहां पे आप जाके देख सकते हो कि आपको समझ में आएगा कि सिविल इंजीनियरिंग कितना बड़ा है और कितनी अपॉर्चुनिटीज है. मतलब आज के तारीख में दिन के 5,000 टेंडर निकल रहे हैं ब्रिज के, हाईवेज के, बाद में ये पोर्ट हार्बर, ये कितना कंस्ट्रक्शन का स्कोप है. बस आपके पास राइट स्किल होगी, राइट नॉलेज और राइट कुछ एक्स्ट्रा होगा, तो ही आप इंडस्ट्री में अच्छे से सस्टेन कर पाओगे. तो इसलिए मैं वो सर जैसे बोले कि जाना चाहिए कंपटीशन में. और सर तो कॉन्टेक्ट है, आपको फुल सपोर्ट करेंगे. जो चाहिए वो कुछ रिसर्च करना है सर के अंदर में आप कर सकते हो, तो कोई आपको बहुत एडवांटेजेस हो जाएगा आगे जाके. लेकिन डिप्लोमा में आप दूसरी बात कि आप बेसिक्स क्लियर रखो, जो भी आपके कॉन्सेप्ट है उसके. आजकल तो यूट्यूब वगैरह पे सब मिल जाता है, आपको नहीं समझ रहा है तो यूट्यूब पे कोई एनिमेशन वीडियो देख लो. ये आपको जैसे मैंने इसमें दिखाया एकदम एनिमेशन सिंपल लैंग्वेज में, यही चीज आप पढ़ने जाओगे तो आपको शायद प्रॉब्लम मतलब थोड़ा नहीं समझेगा ये. तो सर से पूछ सकते हो, सर भी आपको कोई रिसोर्स बता देंगे, लिंक बता देंगे, तो आपको बहुत एडवांटेज हो जाएगा ये सब में. तो यही है कि कुछ भी है प्रोजेक्ट्स, ये एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज में पार्टिसिपेट करो, बहुत आपको एडवांटेज मैं लिख के देता हूँ, बहुत फायदा होगा आपको आगे जाकर. आप याद करोगे कि हाँ मैं यहाँ पे गया था, आज मेरे को इसका फायदा हो गया था. आपका कॉन्फिडेंस बढ़ेगा, आपका कम्युनिकेशन बढ़ेगा. आपको बड़े बड़े लोगों के साथ बात करने का थोड़ा सा कॉन्फिडेंस आएगा, डर निकल जाएगा। स्टार्टिंग में डर लगता है, मुझे भी बहुत डर लगा था, लेकिन एकदम जब से डर जाने लगा अभी मेरे पास एकदम फ्रीली हो गया, मैं किसी से भी एकदम कॉन्फिडेंटली बात कर सकता। तो मतलब साइट पे वगैरह सब आपको वो यूजफुल होगा, इसलिए आप जितना जाओगे पार्टिसिपेट करो या किधर भी जाओ, थोड़ा सा एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर एक्टिविटी पे भी ध्यान दो और इस सब पे करो, टेक्निकली घुसो। आपको IITs वगैरह की कॉम्पिटिशन होती है, उसमें जाओ, आपको पता चलेगा कितने लोग कहाँ कहाँ पे क्या लेवल पे कर रहे हैं। तो इसलिए जो सर बोले सही है, तो मैं भी इतना सारा सब जितना सर का गाइडेंस था, हमारा सर भी गाइड भी सर ही थे, तो इसलिए सर का ये था, इसलिए हम सक्सेसफुल हुआ जहाँ पे हूँ। ओके।